Yeah, I will gather you and blow upon you in the fire of my wrath, and ye shall be melted in the midst thereof. As silver is melted in the midst of the furnace, so shall ye be melted in the midst thereof. And ye shall know that I, the Most High, have poured out my fury upon you. Oh yeah, believe this. That's our power. That's the power we're talking about. So that's why we gotta be saved. So we'll be melted. As the Most High say he's gonna do. Don't get it twisted. Look at 2 Peter. 2 Peter, the first chapter, and verse 11. Searching what or what manner of time the spirit of Mashiach Yahushua, which was in them, did signify, when it testified beforehand the sufferings of Mashiach Yahushua and the glory that shall follow after we suffer. Unto whom it was revealed that not unto themselves, but unto us, they did minister the things which are now reported unto you by them that have preached the gospel unto you with the Holy Spirit sent down from heaven, came in Acts the second chapter, the Holy Spirit, which things the angels desire to look into. You see? The angels desire to look into. But they can't. Because they can't look but one side. See, the angels on the right side, or the angel on the left side. Here we are dealing with both sides, especially during the time that we're in now, because Esau is the worst of the heathen, you know, the most wicked in all the world. So we really learning wickedness and evil as we see it in our time now. That's why you can't be blind to your surroundings and the things that you're dealing with. So I say, be wise as serpents, but what? Harmless as doves. So you can't be so, get so righteous that the things that's around you, you're gonna miss out on because you're too overly righteous and don't know what's going on in the world. Better hear what he's saying. You gotta hear this because you can mess around and be too late. It'd be too late. Look at St. John 10 and 10. He said, a thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. So if you don't know anything about the thief that come to kill and steal and destroy, what do you think he's gonna do to you? He gonna steal from you, he gonna kill you if he can, and destroy you. I am come that they might have life. Mashiach Yahushua came to show us that through him we can have life, everlasting life. We can be saved from our enemies. We can be saved from the hand of all that hate us. And that they might have it more abundantly. That's what we want, with plenteousness. That's already prepared for us. Plenteousness is already prepared. We just gotta get our minds together. And remember that the kingdom is prepared for us. He said he's going to prepare a place for us. It's already prepared. Just wait on us to get ourselves together, people. What is it going to take? Revelation 3. Oh, this is the third chapter. Verse 21. Revelation 3 and 21. To him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame. When he was on this earth, he overcame, so let that mind be in you that was in the Mashiach Yahushua. He overcame so we can overcome. And am set down with my Father in his throne. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. Revelation 5 and 21. Revelation 5 and 10, Salakia. verses 5 and 10. And hath made us unto our power kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth. Ain't gonna be in no fourth dimension somewhere. We're gonna reign right here on the earth. He made unto our power, Mashiach El Shai, both kings. Some gonna be kings and some gonna be priests. The kings gonna be 144,000. That's a ruling power. 12,000 of each of the tribes of Israel. And the priests gonna minister the law to the people. Luke 22 and 30. Luke 22 and 30. That ye may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom, and sit on thrones as powers and authority, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. That's what he told them they're going to be able to do. The 12 apostles going to sit on thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel. Look at Revelation 19 and 9. Revelation 19 and 9. And he said unto me, write, blessed are they which are called unto the marriage supper of the Lamb. And he said unto me, these are the true sayings of the Most High. See. Blessed are they which are called unto the marriage supper of the Lamb. Wow. Can you imagine? We can't even imagine how great that supper is going to be. Beyond our imagination. Whatever we can eat in this, these be kingdoms. Look at, speaking of that, go to Matthew 22. And look at this parable that Mashiach El Shai spoke of. And then Mashiach El Shai answered and spake unto them again by parables or riddles, and said, the kingdom of heaven is like unto a certain king which made a marriage for his son, and sent forth his servants to call them that were bidden to the wedding. And they would not come. They didn't want to come. Again, he sent forth other servants, saying, tell them which are bidden, behold, I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and my fatlings are killed, and all things are ready. Come unto the marriage. I can call around to our people to tell them, hey, everything is ready. It's prepared, people. Everything is ready. It's prepared. Come on to the wedding, that you may sup with the Mashiach Abishai at his table in his kingdom. Again, verse 4, again he sent forth other servants, saying, tell them which are bidden, behold, I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and my fatlings are killed, and all things are ready. Come unto the marriage. But they made light of it. Get out of here, we don't want to hear that. And went on their ways. I'd be telling, hey man, y'all got to come in and start writing this truth. Everybody doing whatever they want to do. Like they did in the days of Noah. And they made light of it, like it's a light thing. Oh, I ain't got to worry about it. He ain't came yet. I ain't worried about him coming. They went on doing their own thing in the world. They made light of it. And went their ways. One to his farm, another to his merchandise, you know. Went back to working. Like, oh, I got to work. Oh, I got to work. I got to work. I got to do this. I got to do that. Excuses. He would have said, one to his farm, another to his merchandise. And the remnant took his servants and entreated them spitefully and slew them. But when the king heard thereof, he was wroth. He got angry. And he sent forth his armies and destroyed those murderers and burned up their city. See, they got angry. They killed them. And the king heard thereof, and he was wroth. And he sent forth his armies, and destroyed those murderers, and burned up their cities, because they didn't want to come. Then said he to his servants, the wedding is ready, but they which were bidden were not worthy. See? The kingdom was prepared, but they that are bidden were not worthy, because they didn't take the time to do what was necessary to be sitting at the table with a Mashiach Yahushua. He said, go ye therefore into the highways, and as many as ye shall find, bid to the marriage. So those servants went out into the highways and gathered together all as many as they found, both bad and good. And the wedding was furnished with guests. Both bad and good. And the wedding was furnished with guests. And when the king came in to see the guests, he saw there a man which had not a wedding garment. And he said unto him, friend, how camest thou in hither not having a wedding garment? And he was speechless, couldn't say nothing. He was speechless. Then said the king to the servants, bind him hand and foot, and take him away, and cast him into outer darkness. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth, for many are called, but few are chosen. Then went the Pharisees and took counsel how they might entangle him in his talk. So she's speaking in parables, so how are we going to entangle him in his talk? You see how wise he was in the parable that he's saying, you know. Because this garment, meaning it wasn't the righteousness. See, the garment is the righteousness of the saints, but they wasn't righteous. That's why he's saying what he's saying. Because they didn't walk in the righteousness of the Most High. That's why I said, why you come? And you didn't have a garment of righteousness on. That's what it means. Look at Revelations 2 and 26. And he that overcometh, so we got to overcome, like he overcame, and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations. So we got to keep the law, such commandments of the Most High, to the end. And to that man of Israel, he's going to give power over the nations. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron, which is the laws of the Most High. And as the vessels of a potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I received of my Father. See? You're going to break these nations down by what? The law of the Most High. Like I say, you're going to serve him, or they're going to perish. Just looking for... And look at Revelations 7 Revelation 7 and verse 14. It says, and I said unto him, sir, well, let's read verse 13. It says, and one of the elders answered, saying unto me, what are these which are arrayed in white robes? Remember, they didn't have a garment. They didn't have a garment. But he said in Matthew 22, 12, well, I'll read verse 11. It says, and when the king came in to see the guests, he saw there a man which had not on a wedding garment. And he said unto him, friend, how camest thou in hither not having a wedding garment? And he was speechless. He didn't know what to say. See, how you come in here and you ain't have a wedding garment? He was speechless. Right? Okay, so it says, and he said to me, verse 14 of Revelation 7 chapter, these are they which came out of great tribulation and have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. See? We have come out of great tribulation, some tribulation, and sacrifice and follow the Mashiach Yahushai to keep the Most High's law, such commandments, and be justified in our faith in the Mashiach Yahushai. And when you go to Revelation 3 and 4, it says, thou hast a few names even in Sardis, which have not defiled their garments, and they shall walk with me in white, for they are worthy. He that overcometh, the same shall be clothed in white raiment, and I will not blot out his name out of the book of life. You see? But I will confess his name before my Father and before his angels. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit said unto the churches. See? So this raiment is the ones that follow the Mashiach Yahushua, confessed him, and followed the law, statutes, commandments of the Most High. That's what it's talking about. They didn't have that, therefore, you're going to cast them out into outer darkness. They're going to be gnashing their teeth and wailing, crying. And that's how we're going to sit at the supper of Mashiach Yahushua. Look at Revelations 15, Revelations 16 and 15. Well, I said, behold, I come as a thief. You don't know when a thief is coming. See, he's coming as a thief. Blessed is he that watches, that's watching out,